Well, good evening, everyone, and thank you for coming. We really appreciate your support, not only for the graduates, but this program, which I think is more of a movement and one that's just starting. As you know, this is the first year, and it's only going to get better. We're the best year, but it's only going to get better. I was told I need to do this in 3 minutes. Sorry, Trent, it's going to be four. Because I wanted to first just talk a little bit about this roller coaster ride that I'm sure many of you have been on along with me and millions of others these last few weeks after tragedies, feelings of anger and hopelessness, sadness, and more anger. We are in discouraging times. We are at a tipping point, a critical juncture that requires us to push reset, practice compassion with ourselves and others, reach out to our allies, and create a more cohesive, collective movement. To do this, we need more troops on the ground. Forgive me for the military analogy, but in these times it fits. Because whether you accept it or not, we are at war with discrimination, hate, and violence, and it is imperative that we reevaluate our strategies. The good news is that CPI is already doing that. For over a year now, they have invested in one of the best strategies we all need to get behind, and that is to prepare and place more progressive leaders of color in decision-making positions such as boards and commissions. I was not prepared with statistics, but I don't think you need proof that men, and particularly women of color, are severely underrepresented in all levels of government and leadership positions. In fact, the number of women in both state and federal legislatures has gone down. From my research, boards and commission representation in San Diego is abysmal. If there's one thing we've learned in recent times, it's that we can no longer react and address symptoms of the problem. We must be proactive and address the root from within to pass policies that improve the lives of the underserved communities in San Diego County. The only way to do that is increase representation of our communities in positions that can change systems and structures. BCLI is the route to getting us there. Yes, there are other programs in San Diego, and I understand they're quite good. But what BCLI does is it incorporates many of the same elements, but goes deeper into developing personal missions and skill building around key issues in San Diego that perpetuate and deepen poverty, such as the housing crisis, economic inequity, such as wage suppression and theft, labor and immigrants' rights violations, transportation and environmental injustices. The approach BCLI took was powerful. It started in the first session. I don't think anyone was planning on crying, but several of us did, including me. I have no shame. We were tasked with the exercise simply called My Story, where we were asked to draw and tell our story of who we were and what has influenced our lives. At first, mostly strangers with unique backgrounds tapping into our own roots of inequities, injustice, and discrimination, sharing openly and vulnerably with one another, connecting and making a collective commitment to learning and supporting one another through our journeys. It was quite powerful. I can't speak for all of us, but I know that for me, it brought me back to why I do this work and a greater sense of belonging. You see, I have been stagnant, succumbing to the pressures of the daily grind, spending time on things that were not important, which took me further and further away from my truth and my mission. So BCLI was more than just a leadership program. It was a transformative experience that inspired a renewed sense of power, hope, and purpose for me. Not only do I feel more confident, knowledgeable, and competent to serve on any board or commission, but I'm now more motivated to serve my community alongside these incredible leaders. And please take the time to get to know each and every one of my fellow cohort. They are incredible people, and you will see their names again and again, because they have a lot of incredible incredible energy and so much to give to this community. To my new friends and allies, what a privilege and honor to have shared this journey with each of you, knowing that you are out there taking strides towards making San Diego healthier, safer, and more prosperous for us all, gives me hope and affirmation that we will win this war. On behalf of BCLI's first and best cohort, I want to thank CPI and the board, especially Trin. Trin, where are you, Trin? Yay, Trin! Our fearless leader. Thank you for investing in us and the future board leaders and commissioners. We hope to make you proud. I also want to thank the incredible speakers that spent their Saturday with us. The connections we made with these amazing individuals in each other was a real highlight of the program. Finally, a big thank you to you all, our new allies, our families and friends. It is through your support that we will continue this important work and make a difference here in San Diego and beyond. I leave you with these words by a poet and activist, Audre Lorde, that I recently was turned on to by a powerful young woman who spoke at the Latino Memorial for the Orlando victims over the weekend. When I dare to be powerful, to use my strength in the service of my vision, then it becomes less and less important whether I'm afraid. Si se puede.